automatically qualified for the 2022 edition of the T20 World Cup. Which are these 8 teams and on what basis have they qualified? I'm going to tell you that in this edition of News Tracker. Uske baad, West Indies cricketer Chris Gayle has said that he is semi-retired. What does that mean and does that mean that he will be continuing to play more matches for his team? I'm going to tell you that today as well. Aur sabse ant mein, Harbhajan Singh has picked his all-time T20 11. Which players have we included and which players have we left out? I'm going to tell you that. Stay tuned to find out. Hello everybody, my name is Preksha Jain and welcome to another News Tracker video. Before I begin, I hope you all are doing well and taking care of yourself. Make sure that you like this video and also subscribe to Crick Tracker. And now without any further ado, let's find out what's new in the world of cricket. Qualified for the Super 12 stage of the 2022 edition of the T20 World Cup. Now, which are these 8 teams? They are India, Australia, New Zealand, Afghanistan, Bangladesh, South Africa, England, and of course Pakistan. Now, this has been decided in the following format. It was decided that the winners as well as the runners-up of the 2021 edition will of course automatically qualify along with the next 6 highest-ranked teams in the ICC rankings. Now, the deadline for deciding this was set to be November 15th, but this is what has happened. West Indies, after losing their last match against Australia, have slipped to the 10th position in the ICC rankings, and their ranking will not change until the deadline, that is November 15th. So they are automatically out of the Super 12 stage in the next edition of the T20 World Cup. And on their place, Bangladesh have automatically qualified because they are at the 8th position in the ICC rankings, even after losing all 5 of their Super 12 matches in this edition. At the same time, Sri Lanka, they played the group stage this season as well, and they will be playing in the group stage in the next year as well, since they are at the 9th position still. While West Indies cricketing legend Chris Gayle, after being dismissed for 15 runs in the last match against Australia, had signalled that he has retired from international cricket. He even walked off to an ovation from the crowd as well as his teammates and even raised his bat to the crowd. But now he has revealed that he is only semi-retired and will sign off from the game in front of his home crowd in Jamaica. However, he has confirmed that this was his very last World Cup game. What else has he said on the matter? I'm going to tell you that now. He says, "I'm semi-retired, I'm one away. I was just having some fun today, put everything that happened aside. I was just interacting with the fans in the stands and just having some fun, seeing as it's going to be my last World Cup game. I'd love to play one more World Cup, but I don't think they will allow me." Gayle said this after the match between Australia and West Indies. And the fans will of course be very happy to hear that they will be able to watch Gayle play for one last time. Well, veteran Indian spinner Harbhajan Singh has picked his all-time T20 11. As the captain of his team, no points for guessing, he has picked the former Indian skipper MS Dhoni. And which other players has he picked? Let's find out. Harbhajan Singh picked India's Rohit Sharma as well as West Indies' Chris Gayle as his openers. And for the number 3 slot, the Terminator went for England's Joss Butler. He said that the English batter is reliable and has the ability to dictate terms after getting set. At number 4, Harbhajan picked Shane Watson, and he also said that he had the potential to put in all-round performances and help his team win matches. After that, for the 5th and 6th position, Harbhajan went for South Africa's AB de Villiers as well as MS Dhoni. And for the 7th and 8th position, Harbhajan Singh picked West Indies cricketers Wayne Bravo as well as Kieran Pollard, and he also said that Pollard could also be slotted up the order if the situation demands so. For the bowlers, Harbhajan Singh picked the wily Sunil Narayan, who has piled his trade in numerous T20 leagues around the world. And finally, for his 2 specialist fast bowlers, Harbhajan went for Lasith Malinga as well as Jasprit Bumrah. Well, what do you think of Harbhajan Singh's all-time T20 11? Let us know in the comment section below. And that's all we have in this edition of News Tracker. My name is Preksha Jain and I'll see you very soon in the next edition. But if you haven't yet liked, shared and commented on this video, what are you waiting for? Do also subscribe to Crick Tracker and lastly follow all our social media handles, including our Telegram channel, because there you'll find fantasy tips for your fantasy team and you wouldn't want to miss out on that. Lastly, do take care of yourselves and stay safe. Goodbye.